Hello everyone, in this session you will learn about History Class 8 Chapter 12, India After Independence. New India. India became independent in 15 August 1947. After that it faced a lot of challenges. After partition, 8 million refugees came into country from Pakistan. Then there was a problem of princely states. Almost 500 of them ruled by Maharajas and Nawabs, each of whom had to be persuaded to join a new nation with the support of Vallabhai Patel. India's population was 345 in 1947. Majority of the people lived in villages and they are mostly farmers and agricultural laborers. Constitution written. Between December 1946 to November 1949, there are almost 300 Indians involved in the series of meetings on the country's political future. The meetings of Constitution Assembly was held in New Delhi and Indian Constitution was adopted in 26th January 1950. First feature of the Constitution was the adoption of Universal Adult Franchise. It means voting power to all Indians. All Indians above the age of 21 has the right to vote in state and national elections. Second feature, granted equality before the law. It means all the people and including Muslims, Parsis, Jains, Sikhs and every religion and every community and every caste people has same rights and same opportunities before the law. Third feature is reservations for tribals, untouchables, poorest and disadvantaged peoples. Constitution showed to balance these competing claims by providing three lists of subjects as Union State and Concurrent List. Union List consists of taxes, defenses and foreign affairs. State List consists of subjects such as health and education. Concurrent List consists of subjects such as agriculture and forest in which both governments have responsibilities. Language. Hindi is regarded as an official language. English used in court, service and communication between one state to another. Framing of Indian Constitution was headed by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. He is also the chairman of drafting committee whose supervision the document was finalized. Formation of states. Both Prime Minister and Deputy Prime Minister Vallabhai Patel were against the creation of linguistic states. It means states were formed according to languages. The protest arising for demanding states as linguistic states. Potti Srirumalu is the person who is the Gandhian leader who died fasting for the separate states for Telugu speakers. Thus, on 1st October 1953, new states of Andhra Pradesh came into being. After creation of Andhra Pradesh, other people demanding separate states. A state reorganization committee was set up and submitted its report in 1956. Recommending the redrawing of districts and provincial boundaries to form compact provisions of Assamese, Bengali, Oriya, Tamil, Malayalam, Kannada and Telugu speakers. The large Hindi speaking area of North India also divided into several states. After that, in 1960, bilingual state of Bombay divided into Marathi and Gujarati speakers. In 1966, Punjab divided into Punjab and Haryana. Punjab is mostly lived Sikhs and Haryana for Haryanavi or Hindi people. Planning for development. Setting up planning commission in 1950 by the chairman Jawaharlal Nehru to help design and execute suitable policies for economic development. there was a broad agreement on what was called mid economy model. Both state and private sector play important and complementary roles in increasing production and generating jobs under the broad agreement of mixed economy model. And in 1951, the first planning commission, that means first 5-year plan, was set up. In this, the main objective is self-sufficiency in food production and agriculture. In 1956, second 5-year plan was formulated. Its focus on development of heavy industries such as steel and on the building of dams. Nations 60 years on. On 15 August 2007, a nation celebrated its 60th Independence Day with its unity and democracy. It faced 13 elections since independence to 2007 and hundreds of state and local elections. Some parts of India had got benefited a great deal from economic development. Some parts, the people live in below the poverty line. Whatever the matter is, there is equality before the law for every citizen. This is the key notes for today's session. You can pause the video and take notes. Thank you. You can follow us on Instagram and Gmail. Thank you.